Greetings, people. Paul Muckle here. Today is September 12th, 2012. It's around 4 a.m. Great news, breaking news. 9/11 terror plot foiled. You know, serious thing. Hold on. People, as you all know, right, I cannot talk too much about the case, right, but as you all know, this is serious, right? Before I get into the terror plot, and you all really need to listen what took place today, but let me show you all the serious orient system real quick, okay? And then get to the point. Okay, that's serious right here. The video orient belt. They're very loose there. Hey people, every star, right? The four bright stars in the sky are running from my house right now. If you don't know that, that's one star right there. That's three, two of them right there. The third one is right there. The Orion Belt one. One, two, three. Put them in a little bit further. One, two, three. Start of the Orion Belt, right? Okay. And beside them, we have them together right there, two of them. Yeah. Over here we have Riga. Okay. We have Riga over here. Over here, Beetlejuice. Beetlejuice is up top. My military. I want to get this story. Anyway, okay. On top, okay, so I'll show you all. I'm gonna show you all the four brightest stars in the night sky, right? Okay. Well, four brightest heavenly bodies. Because one of you are gonna tell me the moon is not a star, so just not to get into any argument with you guys about that. The four brightest heavenly bodies in the night sky, I'm gonna show them to you all. First, we have Sirius right here, right? Okay, we got Sirius right there. Focus. Kinda hazy, but anyway. Yes, you're right, you're right. And then above Sirius, way up here, we have, this is Venus or Jupiter. I'll say more like Jupiter. Top of Jupiter. Okay. Jupiter up here. And then Jupiter. Let me get Sirius again. I didn't get him good enough. Come on, Sirius. But my gate. Yeah, no, the light pole, the two trees in front of my house, right? Right in front of those two trees. Look what's right on top of the two trees, look at that. You see? The two trees right there. In front of my neighbor's house and my house. Yeah. The obelisk. Right above the obelisk. We got the moon and Venus. I did Jupiter, I don't know, but I think it's Venus. Venus and the moon together. Anyway, so the story I'm going to tell you all, right? terror plot has been foiled, people. As you all know, the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, with Martha Cox, who's the Attorney General, have been harassing me for the past, since April, harassing me, charging me with terror plots, you know what I'm saying? Charging me with intimidation of witness, charging me with threatening to commit a crime, charging me with wiretapping, and charging me with stalking, threatening to kill a federal judge. And we went to court, and they locked me up for 64 days, you know, without my being I had me locked up for 64 days from May 1st until July 3rd, they had me locked up for. And then they let me out of jail with a bracelet on my leg with a GPS. You know, I can't go into certain areas. When I go to the federal court, I have to be frisked and I have to be escorted to the federal court by federal marshals. So those are the orders, and I got to set up certain zones. And anyway, for the past 3 months, right, they've been trying to indict me into the Superior Court, right, trying to indict me, you know, so they could give me capital punishment, you know, they could charge me like a terrorist and give me 15, 20 years in prison. These people were really trying to bury me, people. They were really trying to bury me under the prison. They tried to indict me on these bullshit charges, people. And then they threatened me not to tell you all what was going on. I swear to you, people, they took away my First Amendment right. Okay, I'm not even supposed to talk to you all about it, but you know, I am speaking because I filed a lawsuit in the federal court. I filed a lawsuit in the Brockton court, and they removed it to the federal court. So part of my complaint is that they violated my 8th Amendment right by telling me I cannot come on YouTube and tell my friends what happened to me. Okay, they forbid me from telling you guys what they did to me. Could you believe that, people? A judge took away my First Amendment right. On record, he forbid me from speaking about what was done for me. And when I say he forbid me from mentioning names, directly or indirectly, which is the same as if I speak about the case, I'm speaking about it indirectly. But I filed a multi-billion dollar lawsuit. It's in the federal court, and they could lock me up all they want, but somebody's gonna pay me for violating my First Amendment right. Tell me what I could say, what I can't say. Somebody's gonna pay me for that. And anyway, like I was saying, right, they try to indict me, people. They've been trying to indict me, and today, and I went to court yesterday, 9/11. I went to court, and good news, they failed to indict me. The bastards failed to indict me. They lost that one. So now the case got kicked back down to the law court now. And they're in confusion. They're in confusion, people. They don't even know. It's like the DA, they don't even want the case. And the male DA, my lawyer had put in a motion to dismiss the case, because how are they going to say it's a federal judge? But they're not being a particular. They don't say what I said to this federal judge, how I threatened him, how am I going to kill him, how I'm going to, whatever, what am I going to do? I mean, what are the charges? Am I going to kill him? Am I going to blow him up? They it's what they accuse me of, people, of water bottle bombs and killing. So what are the charges? What am I being charged with? I mean, they throw all this stuff, everything but the kitchen sink toward me, but they don't build up particulars. And then they didn't have no probable cause hearing to determine the crime that I was charged with. So anyway, my attorney asked the federal marshal to produce evidence that they collect against me, that they checked this federal judge. The federal marshal, Washington DC, called my attorney. These people, this case is all up to Washington DC. That's how far this case went, my case. Washington DC called my attorney and tell him they're not gonna give him anything. He gotta get it from the state. Give me a second. Tape's about to stop. So Washington DC called my attorney and told him they cannot share any information on him. He have to get it from the state. So far, since my people, my attorney been asking the state, give us this evidence, show us how did Mr. Muckle threaten this jail, we want to know. And they haven't been able to do it because it's all, no, well, we're going to indict him, we're going to indict him, trying to scare me. So, I'm telling my attorney, let them indict, I'm telling him I'm scared, but at the same time, I'm like, let them indict me, because I know once they indict me in the Superior Court, the case going to get thrown out, because the Superior Court, you can't bring a bullshit case in the Superior Court and think the judge is going to take it. So I know once you go to the Superior Court, it's going to get thrown out. So, today, 9/11, we get great news. They failed to indict me. So now they kick the case back to the lower court now. So anyway, so my attorney asked to dismiss the case because they didn't say how I threatened this judge or nothing anyway. So the prosecutor now, the judge tell the prosecutor, well, you need to turn over to him the evidence and you need to give him a bill of particulars. You need to give it to this man. I can't order, if you don't have it, I cannot order you to get it, but call the U.S. Marshal, get it from them. I will be nice, just give him a phone call. And the DA is there, the same one who revoked my bail and my first, the same one who tell the judge that Mr. Muckle is under investigation for threatening a federal judge. Okay, he told the judge that and revoked my bail, so now, today now, it was his turn to get grind. So now he was mouthing after the judge, and the judge is talking, and the judge said, hey, you don't want to do that. It's a female judge to people, a female judge, she was on my side. And she's new, I never seen her before. So it's a new judge I got on the case today, right? So she was like, hey, you don't want to do that. Don't interrupt when I'm talking. And the judge said, I cannot force you. If you don't have it, I cannot force you to give it to him, but you can at least call him federal marshal and find out and I'd really help him, give it to him. He said, matter of fact, next time you come to court, I want you to have it. So he's there mouthing out. The judge said, you know something? I'm ordering you to do it. So now the judge said, I don't have an order. That's what the judge told my attorney. Can you write me up an order? So now my attorney got to write up an order, ordering the district attorney to produce evidence, bill of particulars of how I threatened this federal judge. What did I say to him? How did I threaten him? I mean, they have, in this case, they have me threatening to plant water bottle bombs, me threatening to kill. I got heart in my hand. I mean, people, the most ridiculous charges they put against me, but I cannot say too much because they're gonna try to lock me up. But like I say, I don't mind because every day I spend in prison, I want $100 million, okay? I know I'm not gonna get it, but I'm gonna make some sense, make somebody broke, okay? Somebody's gonna lose their job behind messing with Paul Muckle. So anyway, and it's in the federal court. Like I said, the civil suit is in the federal court. So now we are keep violating my First Amendment right. The federal judge is watching you all. So anyway, the judge ordered the district attorney to produce evidence that I threatened this federal judge, how I threatened this federal judge, what I said to him. And the evidence doesn't exist because people, y'all see my videos, everything I say about this federal judge, I said it under my First Amendment right to free speech. Matter of fact, as much as the cursed judge out, I have a respect for him because he's the one who made me fight people. People, I swear to you, you know, this federal judge said to me, Mr. Muckle, do not win the battle and lose the war. And he would tell me, he was trying to force me to settle the case. And I'm like, but wait a minute, that don't make no sense. The battle is for my house. The war is for the people's house. So if he's telling me, do not win the battle and lose the war, he's telling me, don't take my house and lose my objective, which is the people. So I set the sign, and that's why I started fighting and pretending that I didn't like him. But then he disrespected my mother, and I didn't really like that. So that's why I really started cussing him out really bad. But otherwise, if he didn't disrespect my mother, I would have loved him more. But anyway, like I was saying, all this is part of the plan. While they thought they were plotting against me, the entire universe was plotting against them, okay? Okay, I only have 15 minutes and 30 seconds, so I don't have much more to say. I'm afraid I think my time is up. Anyway, so people, like I said, 9/11 terror plot foiled. They failed to indict me, and they're never going to convict me either. They will never convict me, people. Remember, I told you all that they're not going to convict me. One love, one heart, one destiny for all humanity. Paul McCarthy, and I'm out. You're never going to indict me. You're never going to convict me. Silly rabbits.